Please get ready for transcription number 153 at 80 words per minute. 5 seconds. Start. Madam Chairman, I support the demands for grants of the Ministry of Agriculture. During the last 65 years, the country has made tremendous progress in the field of agriculture and irrigation. The first Prime Minister of our country, late Shri Jawaharlal Nehru, had given top priority to agriculture, and it was his endeavor to make the country self-reliant in the matter of food grains. It was for this reason that several dams and several projects were set up in the country. Due to the efforts of the Congress government, today our country is self-reliant in the matter of food grains. You are aware that the farmer is the backbone of the country, but he is neglected by both the state and the central governments regarding remunerative prices. It is true that the farmer has no association or trade union spirit, and the agricultural sector is an unorganized sector. The position of the farmer is very miserable, and it is true that the farmer is born in debt, lives in debt, and dies in debt. The government has withdrawn the subsidy on fertilizers and pesticides, and the government has also removed the control on their prices. The prices of fertilizers and pesticides have gone up abnormally, and the cost of labor and cultivation has also gone up abnormally. The price of groundnut has fallen down to Rs 700 from Rs 1200. The price of sunflower has fallen down to Rs 800 from Rs 1000, and the price of cotton has also fallen down to Rs 800 from Rs 1500. The farmers are finding it very difficult to dispose of their stocks even at the prevailing price, and the crop produced is lying for want of purchase at the remunerative price. Therefore, the farmers are very much agitated, and they held dharnas and hartals. Farmers have borrowed loan from banks and money lenders who are putting a lot of pressure on the farmers for the repayment of loans. I learnt reliably that they are going to commit suicide in order to get over the difficulty when they are unable to bear the situation. I understand that the Agricultural Prices Commission fixes the prices, support prices for agricultural commodities. I think that the APC members have no knowledge of agriculture and agricultural commodities. The APC has fixed the support price of groundnut at Rs 750 per quintal, and of sunflower at Rs 800 per quintal. The cost of production of groundnut is double than the cost of sunflower seeds, whereas the APC has fixed the support price of sunflower at rupees 800 per quintal, much more than the groundnut seeds, which shows their ignorance. It clearly shows that they do not have any idea about the cost of production of each crop. Government is collecting thousands of crores of rupees on the agricultural commodities towards central sales tax and state sales tax, whereas the contribution of the government towards the farmer is negligible compared to the services that are being rendered by the government towards the industrial sector, public undertakings, welfare schemes, etc. Unless the government takes proper measures to safeguard the interests of farmers, there is every possibility that production of agricultural commodities will steeply fall down, which will have an impact on the consumer's price and government's economy in the near future. There is every need for the intervention of the government. The government should purchase sunflower, groundnut, and cotton through NAFED, NAFED, and NCDC. The remunerative price of rupees 1200 for groundnut, rupees 1000 for sunflower, and rupees 1500 for cotton should be announced. In this regard, I, along with some other members of parliament, met Honorable Agriculture Minister and also the Prime Minister and explained the situation. I hope and trust the government will do justice to the farmers. Mr. Chairman, sir, I am grateful that you have given me an opportunity to express my views on the budget, particularly relating to the Ministry of Agriculture. When the Honorable Minister of Finance presented the budget, he stated that farmers are the backbone of this country and that India is predominantly an agricultural country and the farmers have strengthened the economy, but grants for the development of agriculture are so meager that one feels anguished. Madam, 80% of the population lives in villages, and even today their primary occupation is agriculture. Through you, I would like to draw the attention of the House towards the steps taken by the government, which are detrimental to the interests of farmers and agricultural workers. In 1992-93 budget, the government allocated rupees 2000 crores for agriculture, and this year the Minister of Finance has allocated rupees 2400 crores for this purpose. Stop.